Hello friends, welcome to ELS, English Literature Studies with Kaur Harpreet. Today I will discuss about George Crabbe, who is again one of the precursors of the Romantic movement. In my previous videos, I have firstly discussed about transition age, then I have discussed about transition poets, in which Oliver Goldsmith is already discussed, then James Thomson, Thomas Percy, Thomas Chatterton, William Cowper, all these are discussed with their life and works in detail in my previous videos. If you are interested, you can check those videos. Link will be provided in the description box. So without wasting any time, let us start with today's video, that is about George Crabbe, whose time period is 1754 to 1832. So let us start. George Crabbe is an English writer of poems and verse tales, and he is also a surgeon and clergyman. He apprenticed to a doctor at the age of 14, but to pursue his literary interest, he left his medical career, right? And later on, he became clergyman with the help of Burke. He is best known for his early use of the realistic narrative form, also known for his descriptions of middle class and working class, and how he made their life memorable with realistic details of everyday life. Due to these things, he is famous, right? Crabbe is often called the last of the Augustan poets. Why he is called so? Because he followed John Dryden, Alexander Pope, Samuel Johnson in using the heroic couplet. And he handled this heroic couplet with great skill. He emphasized to describe the commonplace realities and miseries of real human life. That is why we can say he used the realistic narrative form, right? If we talk about his style in his form and style of writing, he followed the school of Pope. But in spirit and substance, he was predominantly satiric and didactic. He differed from others in the great humanity of his subjects. It is Crabbe who took bold steps to identify himself with poor people, poor class, and describe their life in great real manner without using any fantasy or without using any fancy words, right? He showed his own individuality of character by setting himself against the traditions, which was very favorite of the writers of the pastorals, writing of painting romantic and idealist pictures of village life. So he showed his own individuality rather following their way of writing, right? George Crabbe completed his unfinished poems and revised others with the help of Edmund Burke. And the time spent with Burke helped him to enlarge his ideas. And it is Edmund Burke who introduced him to Charles, James and Samuel Johnson. And it is very clear that he had a great role in Crabbe's life. Then Crabbe wrote poetry of different kind, poetry of another kind. And when we read about his values, his sensibility, we observe that much of his heroic couplet words belong to the 18th century. He differs from the earlier Augustans in his subject matter to his realistic and unsentimental account of the life of the poor class and middle class. He was a great power of description. Then his first poem, The Library, he published in 1781. And when we talk about this poem, The Library is dull and unimportant, and it is full of trifling reflections on books and readings. And it was his second poem, The Village, which made him name and fixed his character as a poet, corrected and revised by Johnson. Crabbe demonstrated his full power as a poet with this poem. It is written as a protest against The Deserted Village, written by Oliver Goldsmith, which he thought to be sentimental poem. Crabbe describes the life. He described in this poem, The Village, he made good use of observation of life, or we can say it describes the life of villagers, it describes the poverty, their misery, struggles in minute details. All these things are discussed in this poem. And in other words, Crabbe's poem, The Village, was an attempt to portray realistically the misery and degradation of rural poverty. After that, Crabbe published no poetry for the next 22 years. And The Village was his popular success, but was followed by an unworthy successor, the newspaper, in 1785. And then he published no poetry for the next 22 years. After long silence, he returned to poetry with his next work, The Parish Register. It is a poem of more than 2,000 lines. And in this poem, he made use of register of births, deaths, and marriages. In this, he reviews the life of parish to create a compassionate depiction of the life of a rural community. The other works of Crabb followed The Burrow. It is a series of 24 verse letters written to a friend. And in 1812, we have Tales in Verse. After the death of his wife, he met John Murray, who published his next work, Tales of the Hall, in 1819. And this gained him great popularity in the early 19th century. Right? And Crabb's poems have been, we can say, praised by his critics also. Never was any poet at the same time so great and continues a favorite with the critics. His works were collected into 8 volumes, and his influence can be observed on the realism of Thomas Hardy's novels. His verse comforted Sir Walter Scott. When we talk about his stories, these are very profound, and events read are never forgotten. But Crabb just failed of being the artist in words who is able to make the same appeal in all ages. This is his, we can say, drawback. That is why, that is the reason he failed. Yet he is one of the great realists of English fiction, for even considered as a novelist. He is more than this. His poetry is true poetry, although he wrote it under the influence of opium, to which he became much addicted in his later years. In his later years, he became a member of the Literary Society in 1819, and then in 1826 he became magistrate, and he died in 1832. So friends, this is all about my today's topic. I hope you will like the content, and if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications for my upcoming videos. And thanks a lot for watching.